anytime you have a new tool, especially a surgical tool, you really have to look at it and understand what the best uses are for that tool, for patients to understand when it should or should not be used. And so I think this advisory is very informative to both surgeons as well as to patients in understanding more about the use of this surgical tool. Robotic surgery is a way of doing a hysterectomy that could replace an open surgery. Whenever you cannot do open surgery, it's a good thing because slower time to recovery for the patients. But a simpler surgery, maybe a vaginal hysterectomy or a simple laparoscopic hysterectomy without using the robotic tool. So it's important to counsel patients of the best way to do the procedure. If doing it robotically prevents an open surgery, that has an advantage versus if it can be done in a more simple way with less time and less cost, then it makes sense to do it vaginally or laparoscopically. I think it's important for patients when they talk with their gynecologist to really look at themselves as an individual and understand why whatever method of hysterectomy is recommended is the best one for them. It's somewhat more complex surgery that requires the tool of the robot. Having said that, you don't want it to be the extent of complexity that it ends up being a very complicated surgery, then it needs to be done open. So the level of complication, is it simple enough to do it without the robot? Or is it so complex that it needs to be done as an open surgery? Or is it somewhere in between where it is best done using that tool?